Hello and welcome to Saurav's classes. For the detailed study materials, online and live classes, you can always contact to this phone number, and also we can contact with in our website, which is www.saurav'sclasses.com. So in my previous video, I have solved the question of 2013 DSC from question number 1 to 5. Now I am starting with the question number 6. Consider an individual with an utility function of this, where x denote the amount of money available to her, and suppose she has x equals to 100. So she has an option of buying a lottery that cost her 51, and lottery pays her 351 with certain probability, and with certain other probability she gets 0. So assuming A has an expected utility maximizer, which of the following statements are correct? So not prefer to buy a lottery as long as P less than 1, P greater than 0. Certainly prefer to buy a lottery as long as P greater than 0. Prefer to buy a lottery if and only if P greater than 51 by 351. And prefer to buy a lottery if and only if P greater than 51 by 221. Now essentially we have to find out the value of P. Then how to solve the problem? So our utility function is basically 10 root of x, and x is our money income, which is basically 100. So our utility function will be having a value of 100, because 10 times root of 100. And if purchased a lottery that cost rupees 51, therefore what is the net utility? 100 minus 51, which is essentially 49. So with probability P, I earn 351, and with probability 1 minus P, I earn 0. So therefore my expected utility function will be, with probability P, the total utility will be 100 minus 51, which is the cost of the lottery, plus I get 51, plus with probability 1 minus P, I get only utility of 100 minus 51. And this should be strictly greater than the utility in the normal time of not purchasing any lottery. Therefore, after calculating this, we get probability utility 51, so it is 400 plus 1 minus P. Here we will be getting 49, which is greater than 100. Essentially, we are actually trying to derive a condition that under which condition I prefer to buy a lottery. So after solving this, we are getting, so 10 times, so this is 400 plus 1 minus P, because this is our utility function. So this is basically x. This is my ultimate x. So it is 10 minus root of 49 greater than this, so which is 21 minus P times, this is 7 times 10, here we will be getting 10. So essentially we are getting 200 P plus 71 minus P greater than, here I have missed a 10, so it will be 100. Therefore, the calculating probability, the condition will be this. Therefore, the answer will be this. So, my next question based on the on this following condition. So the condition is that suppose that there are two goods which are imperfect substitutes. Let P1, P2 denote the price of good 1 and good 2 respectively, and the demand functions are something like this. So find the equilibrium prices of good 1 and good 2 produced by two different monopolies. So we have to find the quantity produced by the both the monopolies themselves. This means by monopolies 1 and monopolies 2 separately. So how to solve the problem? So first case is, so first let us write the demand functions. The demand function for monopolies 1 is like this: A minus P1 plus B P2 and D2 P1 P2, which will be A minus P2 plus B P1. Now therefore, so when you are solving the profit for the monopolist, so it is like this: P minus C. So for the monopolist 1, the price will be obviously P1 times Q1. So this demand function is essentially the quantity. So we can put the value over here. So A minus P1 plus B P2, and therefore we can differentiate it. As we can see, all are in terms of prices. So this is P1 minus C times minus 1 plus A minus P1 plus B P2 times 1. So equal to 0. Therefore we have A minus P1 plus B P2 equal to P1 minus C. Therefore A plus B P2 minus C times 2 P1. So P1 equals to A plus B P2 minus C by 2. Now for monopolist 2, it will be like this: P2 minus C A minus P2 plus B P1. Now maximizing this with respect to the price P2, we will get something like this. So these are basically the best response functions. Best response functions. Similarly for this, we will get P2 equals to A plus B P1 minus C by 2. Now what we have to do, we have to just equate it. So equating this, we get P1 equals to A minus C by 2 plus B. Now in the place of P2, I am just putting the value of this, which makes it like this. So P1 equals to A minus C by 2 plus, here we have B times A minus C by 2 plus we have B square P1 by 2. Now after rearranging it, we will be having P1 plus P2 equals to 1 minus C, 1 plus C by 2 minus P. So these are essentially the answer. So the correct answer will be this, and that this is the option number, this is the option number A. The next part of the question will be, the next part of the question says that what will be the price if goods are produced by a single monopolist. Goods are produced by a single monopolist. So essentially we need to do a joint maximization of two commodities. So how to do that? We have two demand functions. Which is essentially maximize the profit P1, P2, and P1, P2. We have to maximize it with respect to both, because now both the goods are produced by the same monopolist. So suppose the good one charges P1, or the price of the good one is P1, so we have to multiply it with its demand function plus the commodity 2 with the price P2, and corresponding this. So Now maximize it with respect to P1, which gives A minus P1 plus BP2 times 1 plus P1 minus C minus 1 plus P2 minus C plus B. Similarly, with respect to P2, we have here P1 minus C times B, P2 minus C times minus 1 plus A minus P2 plus BP1 times 1. Now, we have to set both equal to 0 according to the FOCs. So, these are the FOC, and by solving this, we will get P1 equals to P2 equals to A plus C minus BC by 2 times 1 minus B. So, this is the answer of the question. Therefore, P1 equal to P2 is equals to 1 plus C minus BC times 2 1 minus B. This is the option C, and this is the correct option. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. Until next time, thank you.